So today's topic of this video is the hello cervical orthosis. So as we can see in this video, it consists of various components. So one by one we will discuss it. It consists of a metal ring which is mostly a U-shaped ring, but sometimes it is a circular ring also. So it is a U-shaped ring which covers laterally and it covers anteriorly, while it is deficient posteriorly or in the occipital region. The second component is the pins. So it has two anterior pins and we have the two posterior pins. The placement of this pin, these pins we will discuss later on this video. And the third component comes these struts. We have the two anterior and the two anterior and the two posterior struts. Now these struts will attach to the distal part of the orthosis. Now distal part can be in the thoracic region, which is known as hello west orthosis, or distal part can be in the pelvic region, which is hello pelvic orthosis. So this whole orthosis is used to provide immobilization to the cervical spine. So it fixes the skull to the rest of the body. Now mostly it is used in the cases of the upper cervical spine injury, the injuries involving the occipital condyle C1 and the C2 vertebrae. So it is not an ideal orthosis for the subaxial cervical spine injuries, as it is not very efficient in preventing the lateral bending. It is more efficient in preventing the rotational component, but it is less efficient in preventing the lateral bending component of the vertebrae. Now coming upon to the indications. Now firstly, in adults, as it is used in cases of the suboccipital group of the cervical vertebrae, which include the occipital condyle C1 and C2 fractures, it is mostly used. So first indication will come out to be a occipital condyle fracture, or second is the occipital cervical dissociation. Then we have a type 2 stable atlas fracture, then we have the odontoid fracture, then we have the axis fracture, or it is a pars interarticularis fracture, hangman fracture. So overall it is used only in the fractures of the occipital condyle, occipital cervical dissociation, then we have the C1 and C2 fractures. Even in the pediatric group, it is used in these fractures only: atlanto-occipital dissociation, odontoid fracture, C1, C2 dissociation. But rarely it is used in pediatric group of fractures. We can use in case of the subaxial cervical spine injuries also. Now contraindicated, so it is contraindicated, absolute contraindicated in case of the, if it is already a cranial fractures where pin insertion will be difficult, or it is infected area where the pin we are supposed to put, it is already infected, and or it is already injuries, soft tissue injuries present over this region. Coming upon to the relative contraindication is the chest trauma. It can be barrel chest or obesity, and even in the advanced age group, in elderly patient, it is not that preferred orthosis, because it might lead to the respiratory compromise and cardiovascular compromise, plus the complications like pin loosenings are very common. So the results from the hello west orthosis in elderly people is all very poor. Now as we have discussed, it is used in case of C1 and C2 and not in case of the subaxial spine. Now why it is not used in subaxial spine? The first reason and important reason is the lateral bending is not prevented. So there is a phenomena known as snaking phenomena. Now snaking phenomena, due to the contraction of the neck muscles, the middle cervical spine vertebra, they displaces, because the superior and the inferior cervical spine vertebra are much controlled by this orthosis. So the middle one cervical spine vertebra, they displaces from their original side due to the contraction of this cervical spine muscles. So when we do x-ray in lying down position, so it will show a local kyphosis, midline kyphosis, due to the displacement of the cervical spine vertebra due to the contraction of the cervical group of the muscles. While in upright, position, while we'll do X-ray, it will show a normal lordosis, but in lying down position, it will show a focal kyphosis in the midline area. Now, coming upon to the detailed discussion of this ring and the pins. So the ring, the size of the ring is very important. It needs to be 1.5 to 2 centimeter larger than the head circumference, and no point of the ring should be in contact with the skin of the head. Now the pin position is very specific. There is very less margin of error in cases of the pin position. So as we can see in this skull, so we will draw a center midline and there is an equator of the skull. So the anterior pin position should be in the about 4.5 centimeter lateral to the midline plus 1 centimeter. It should be 1 centimeter superior to the orbit. So it comes out to be about a 3/4. So if we draw a line from the midline to the lateral margin of the orbit, so the pin position should be in the 3/4 margin. So if we apply a much medial pin, so it will cause injury to the supraorbital and supratrochlear group of nerves which lie in this region, plus there is a chances of infiltration of the frontal sinus. Now if we will avoid this region and we will come more laterally, so there is a temporalis group of muscle, so it might go into the temporal fossa. Plus during the insertion of this pin, we will ask the patient to close his or eyes, as it will prevent the tenting of the orbicularis oculi muscle. So it should be 4.5 centimeter lateral and 1 centimeter superior to the orbit. So this was all about the anterior pins. Now the posterior pins should be directly at 180 degree. So if the anterior pin is this, the posterior pin will be right here. So it will be at 180 degree to the anterior pin. Similarly on this side, if the anterior pin is here, the posterior pin will be right here. Now posteriorly it should be below the equator. So this is the equator. So it should be below the at 180 degree to the anterior pin. Now while inserting the pin, the amount of the it is a torque controlled screwdriver which is used, and about 6 to 8 inches pound is the amount of torque which should be applied while tightening the pin. And one important thing is that when this anterior pin will be tightened simultaneously, the opposite posterior pin should be tightened. So this was about the pins. Now there is a bar over here which is used to control the flexion and extension, plus we can length of the struts can be extended. So that depends upon the pathology and what pathology we are addressing, and we need to fix it in the hollow in flexion or we need to fix it in the extension. So regarding the tightening of the pin, now once inserted, firstly they need to be tightened after 24 to 48 hours, and then they need to be tightened after 1 week. Care should be pin direct. Care is equally important. Now in pediatric group, the pins need to be more in number to get a better control. So they are about 6 to 8 pins, and the torque with which they are applied is less than the torque applied in the adults. So torque there is about 4 to 6 inches. It is about 4 to 6 inches pound, which is the torque applied in case of the pediatric group. Now there is a question regarding the most common cranial nerve that is injured or involved in case of this anterior pin placement. So it is the abducens nerve, which is a 6th cranial nerve. Now it doesn't cause this injury directly to the nerve, but it is due to traction of the nerve that the 6th nerve is the involved. Now, once the 6th nerve will be involved, it will cause the deficiency of the lateral gauge. The patient won't be able to gauge laterally, plus there will be a diplopia in the patient. Plus the pins, they need to be in the outer bone layer. They need not to be penetrate into the inner layer. Now this shows the type of pin. Now the pin is tapered only in a less, it is very less tapered, and there is a strong substance behind this tapering. So this is due to the fact that it will get a much good hold, as plus it won't be penetrating the inner bone layer. So the wider substance is entirely covering the outer bone layer, plus the tapered area is very less involved in the inner bone layer. So this is the regarding the specific feature of the shape of the pin. Now complications are much more higher in children as compared to the adults, and complications are very high in case of the elderly people. This type of orthosis is mostly avoided in elderly people. So first complication is the loosening. So loosening, if the pins are loosened, we need to retighten in, and even if the retightening is not that perfect, so we need to come to the pin exchange. Second is the infection. Now infection, if we go posteriorly, it will cause infection of the temporalis fossa. If we go anteriorly, it will cause infection of the frontal sinus. Plus the posterior pins are more likely to cause infection, as we have the hair posteriorly, plus the inner bone is thin in this region, and the temporalis muscle over this, it moves with chewing. So infection is more common in the posterior pin as compared to the anterior pin. Now if this pin penetrates the inner bone layer, it will cause brain abscess and dura puncture. Now the supraorbital, as we have discussed, the much anterior pin placement will cause the supraorbital and supratrochlear nerve palsy, and abducens nerve, which is the most common cranial nerve, which is involved because of the traction and not direct penetration, which will affect the lateral rectus muscle and will cause the loss of the lateral gauge. So that was all about the haloorthosis. So briefly summarizing it all. So firstly, it is used only in cases of the occipital condyle C1 and C2 fractures. It is avoided in elderly. It is avoided in elderly, plus it is avoided in case of the head trauma, head infection, soft tissue injury, and chest trauma, chest infection. Most commonly involved nerve is cranial nerve is the abducens nerve, 6th cranial nerve, and the anterior pin placement is very specific. Anterior pin placement should be about 4.5 cm lateral to the midline and 1 cm superior to the orbit. So thank you. Hopefully this was a good discussion. Kindly add to your comments below down, so that if any point is missed or any point was told wrong, so adequate correction and addition could be made. Thank you.